What were the key differences that defined the legendary fight between Bruce Lee and Wong Jack Man? As we delve into the details, the contrasting styles and physical attributes of these two martial artists come to light, offering a fascinating glimpse into what made this fight so extraordinary. The most crucial difference lies in the length of the fight. According to Bruce Lee's supporters, the battle was a swift, high-intensity affair lasting just about 3 minutes. Bruce's speed and aggressive approach overwhelmed Wong, leading to a quick and decisive victory. This version emphasizes Bruce's lightning-fast reflexes and relentless attack, showcasing his superior fast-twitch muscle fibers that allowed him to execute rapid, explosive movements. Imagine the scene. Bruce Lee, with his cat-like agility, relentlessly pursuing Wong Jack Man, landing blow after blow with unparalleled speed. On the other hand, Wong Jack Man's supporters paint a different picture. They describe a prolonged, grueling contest lasting 20 to 25 minutes. Wong's traditional training and endurance were put to the test as he countered Bruce's aggression with skillful dodges and measured responses. This narrative highlights Wong's slow-twitch muscle fibers, which are essential for stamina and sustaining prolonged physical activity. Picture Wong, steadfast and resilient, using his deep-rooted martial arts techniques to withstand Bruce's onslaught and keep the fight going for nearly half an hour. The difference in muscle types plays a significant role in these contrasting accounts. Bruce Lee's explosive power can be attributed to his type 2X muscle fibers, known for their rapid and powerful contractions but quick fatigue. These fibers are ideal for short bursts of intense activity, which aligns with Bruce's aggressive, high-speed fighting style. Meanwhile, Wong Jack Man likely had a higher proportion of type 1 muscle fibers, which are more resistant to fatigue and suitable for prolonged exertion, explaining his ability to endure a longer fight. There's also the genetic predisposition to consider. Bruce's genetic makeup and rigorous training optimized his type 2A and 2X fibers for explosive power. However, this came at the cost of endurance, as these muscle fibers tire quickly. In contrast, Wong's slow-twitch type 1 fibers allowed him to maintain his performance over a more extended period, showcasing the advantages of traditional, endurance-based martial arts training. To illustrate this, think of a lynx chasing a deer. The lynx, with its powerful and explosive muscle fibers, can launch a rapid, high-energy chase. However, if the prey manages to evade those initial, deadly strikes, the lynx's chances of catching it diminish rapidly due to fatigue. Similarly, while Bruce's initial assault might have overwhelmed most opponents, Wong's endurance and traditional techniques allowed him to withstand this initial barrage and extend the fight. This difference in the fight's duration also reflects their differing philosophies. Bruce Lee, dissatisfied with the limitations of traditional Wing Chun, saw this fight as proof that rigid styles could not match the demands of real combat. His relentless pursuit and adaptation during the fight underscored his belief in a more pragmatic, fluid approach to martial arts. This experience was a catalyst for developing Jeet Kune Do, Bruce's revolutionary martial arts philosophy that eschewed fixed patterns for adaptability and practicality. In contrast, Wong Jack Man represented the traditional martial arts ethos, where discipline, endurance, and adherence to established techniques were paramount. His ability to withstand Bruce's ferocious attacks for an extended period, according to his supporters, showcased the enduring value of traditional martial arts training. The dramatic differences in these accounts not only highlight the physical and strategic contrasts between Bruce and Wong, but also reveal the deeper ideological battle that took place in that Oakland studio. How did these contrasting styles and philosophies shape the outcome of the fight? Which narrative holds the truth? And what does this tell us about the evolution of martial arts? Stay tuned for the next part, where we explore how Bruce Lee's cinematic persona matched up against the reality of this legendary confrontation.